Welcome to my channel Dilip's Passion for Trees. This time my talk is on one of the most charismatic trees called Champaka, also known as Joy Perfume Tree, Himalayan Champaka, Golden Champaka, and also called Jade Orchid Tree. Botanical name Magnolia Champaka, previously known as Michaelia Champaka. In Indian languages, other names are Champa, Sonchampa, Champige, Titasopa, Champangi, etc. Sometimes people confuse it with Pagoda Tree. That is Plumeria alba, as it is also called Champa. In the video, you can see with the beautiful conical shape of the tree with lanceolate leaves, golden colored flowers, gray bark, red colored seeds. The tree produces long straight bole as its lower branches set easily. The species has got two varieties and one hybrid. One is Magnolia Champaka variety Champaka, which can grow up to 30 meter height. While the other variety is called Magnolia Champaka variety Pubinardia, which grows up to 50 meter height. Both the varieties produce fragrant yellow flowers. The hybrid variety is called Magnolia cross alba, produces white fragrant flowers but does not produce seeds. The strong and diffusive fragrance of Champaka flowers draw attention of any passerby from distance. The tree generally produces flowers throughout the year, but more during rainy season, that is from June to September in India, and seeds are formed during July to October. Pollination is by beetles and seeds are dispersed by birds and mammals. The species is native to tropical and subtropical South and Southeast Asia, including India. In India, natural occurrence of this species is found in humid tropical evergreen and in moist deciduous forest of Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats and in sub-Himalayan zone of West Bengal, Assam and Bihar. It is also found in Chola forest of peninsular India. In Karnataka state, it occurs in natural forest in the districts named in North Kannada, Chikmagalur, Shimoga, Hassan, Coorg and Chamarajanagar, usually in scattered manner, and it comes up well in open area. The species is valued for its ornamental use, cultural use, perfumery use, medicinal and timber use. As ornamental tree in landscape, the species is widely planted in roadside, park, temple premises and in homestead garden. It is also planted in large size container. It is one of the most favorite trees in Bangalore city, and in fact, one road is named as Champaka Road in Bangalore city. As cultural and religious use, the fragrant flowers of this tree are used for religious offerings. The tree is sacred to Lord Vishnu. In Buddhism, it is believed that 17th Buddha used Champaka tree for receiving enlightenment. A big old Champaka tree called Dodo Champige in Canada, located in Biligiri Rangaswamy Temple Tiger Reserve in Karnataka, is worshipped by native Soliga tribes who compare this tree to Lord Shiva. In South India, the timber is auspicious and used for sariot making and for other temple uses. As perfumery use, the girls and ladies in India use Champaka flowers in their hairs as natural perfume and for beautification. The flowers are floated in a bowl of water to scent the room. The second best perfume in the world, called Joy, is manufactured by using essential oil extracted from Champaka flowers. As natural perfume, different brands of Champaka fragrance oils are available in the market. Champaka flowers are also used to make scented agarbatti, soaps, candles, etc. As medicinal uses, in traditional medicine, different parts of Champaka tree, such as root, bark, flowers, flower buds, seeds, are used to treat different ailments like constipation, fever, cough, skin disease, eye disorder, ulcers, wounds, diabetes, gastric, abdominal tumor, etc., and also as antidote to snake and scorpion venoms. As medicinal uses, in traditional medicine, different parts of Champaka tree, such as root, bark, flowers, flower buds, seeds, are used to treat different ailments like constipation, fever, cough, skin disease, eye disorder, ulcers, wounds, diabetes, gastric, abdominal tumor, etc., and also as antidote to snake and scorpion venoms. However, further evaluations are required in these aspects, and hence registered practitioners should be consulted before use. As timber value, the wood is light, straight-grained with distinct growth rings, yellowish brown to olive brown and shiny. The hard wood is strong and durable and capable to take high polish, excellent for house construction such as door panels, cabinets and for making furniture. Moisture-proof plywood, tea chest, tea boxes, toys, pencils and even for ship and boat building. Since the timber is comparatively cheaper, commonly used as timber in Northeast, especially in Assam. Lastly, let us discuss about cultivation and propagation. The species requires humid and warm climate with average annual rainfall 3000 to 4000 mm and temperature 25 to 38 degrees Celsius. However, in cultivation, it grows in lesser rainfall area also with supportive irrigation. It requires well-drained, fertile loamy soils, very sensitive to fire. Even ground fire is enough to kill mature trees of this species. It requires full sunshine, moderate water, and moderate maintenance. As agroforestry tree, it improves soil pH, increases soil organic carbon and phosphorus availability in soil, as its roots harbor vesicular arbuscular mycorrhizae. If planted for sawn timber, the tree can be harvested in 50 years age. In cultivation, it can reach 27 meter height and 1.72 meter girth with mean annual increment of girth 4.7 to 6.3 centimeter. It can be propagated from seeds by grafting and layering and even from vegetative cuttings using 0.3% IBA solution. Seeds from ripened fruits are collected in August and are to be sown immediately after collection, preferably within 2 weeks. Seeds can be also sown directly in bags and root trainers instead of seed beds. Seeds take about 45 days for complete germination. However, germination starts in 10 to 14 days. Seed origin seedlings take 8 to 10 years for flowering and hence should be used for the purpose of landscaping and in afforestation program. For flower production, farmers should plant grafted plants which give flowers in 1 to 2 years. Generally planted in 3 to 4 meter spacing depending upon variety in 60 centimeter pits. 1 year old tall seedlings are ideal for planting. Nowadays, farmers are growing these species for flower production as profitable tree crop. Success stories are available in Palghar district in Maharashtra, Dharmapuri district in Tamil Nadu, Bangalore rural district in Karnataka. Few farmers in Devanahalli in Bangalore rural district have been growing grafted plants of Champaka variety called Sondaria profitably. One such farmer called Lakshminarayan Babu, you can see in the video, has been getting regular income from Champaka flowers continuously since 2009, grown in 2 acres of his farmland. He proudly said that he got sufficient income from Champaka flowers and part of his income he could utilize for developing his entire farm for growing other profitable crops also. As per his observation, boundary trees produce more flowers. From the success stories of such farmers, it is clear that the species has got lot of potential for growing in agroforestry system as pure block as well as boundary tree along with other economic crops. As per available information, a company located at place called Kanavir in Kolhapur district in Maharashtra has developed own Champaka plantation project and it is using Champaka flowers for manufacturing of Champaka absolute essential oil, which has demand in local and global market. This company is also encouraging new farmers to grow Champaka trees for flowers. Many more Champaka-based industries are required to come up for the benefit of Champaka growing farmers. However, such industries also need continuous supply of adequate flowers for sustenance. Let us grow Champaka trees and conserve it in its natural habitat also. Namaskar.